Hello guys, me again. Continuing the Science with Kemp series now, thank you for watching the videos, I've had some great feedback. To be honest, I thought none of you would give a damn, but you seem to, well, at least some of you have said you seem to, so I'm going to do another one. Something I've been reading and watching and learning about a lot recently is something called flow states. Now, it might sound a bit bizarre on the off, but there's a chap called Stephen Kotler who was originally a journalist, but then also a sort of pseudoscientist. And he has done a lot of research on these things called flow states. And flow states are something that we're all aware of or have been aware of in one way or another. It's a kind of moment in your life or in time where you get so focused that it feels that every action that you perform leads seamlessly into the next thing, hence the name flow states. It's been described in many ways. If you're like a beatnik jazz musician, it's called being in the pocket. If you're an extreme sports person, it's called being in the zone. You know, if you're a musician, you might say you're in the zone and stuff like that. You know, where you have those points in life where you're so ultimately focused on the one thing that you're doing that nothing else matters, and you almost feel like you're a voyeur to what your body is doing, like you're just letting it flow and you're in the flow, as the name suggests. So I'm sure we've all experienced something like that at some point, whether it be at work where you're just so intensely focused on something that the time passes and 5 hours have gone by and you haven't even noticed. Or if you're an artist and you're working on a piece and you're doing some of your best work. Now, flow states have been studied and they're an actual physical manifestation of the brain, the way that our brain chemistry works that allows us to get into this state. And it's all about peak human performance. Now, this Stephen Kotler chap did a lot of research with extreme sports people and wrote a book called, I think it was called Ultimate Human Performance, Studying Ultimate Human Performance or Superhumans or something like that. And the reason he studied extreme athletes is because these people, say you're a snowboarder and you're competing at professional levels, in order for you to stay alive at a basic level or let alone win, you need to be operating in one of these flow states. You need to be at your very, very best. You need to be at the peak of your performance, or there could be horrible consequences because of the extreme thing that you're doing. So these extreme sports people, be it like motocross cyclists, whatever, are very, very good at inducing these states. And this Stephen chap goes on to say that there's around 17 triggers for these flow states. He's been studying it for a long time, how to induce it, how to, you know, get more flow into your life. It's a big part of this whole wellness movement that's been going on recently about the way people are trying to enhance their own self. It's quite interesting. I found it really interesting. And so he's been studying this thing and saying that in a flow state that can last how long, it's like usually a matter of hours, you are 5 times more productive. So he goes on to say that you should go into work on a Monday, spend that day in a flow state and get enough work done to compensate for the entire week just because you were so focused. So business people are all trying to hack this thing and they're all trying to get some of this, more of this stuff in their life. So he says, I don't know all of the triggers. He goes on to explain them, and quite obviously he sells some of this information to people. So he goes on to explain how to build these triggers into your life. A few of them are, I know that there's a creative trigger. So like creativity, the act of being creative, the act of trying to create things can help induce these states. Another thing is like your environment. There's various environmental triggers. So if you have complex environments around you, it's much more likely to induce these states of flow where you're more creative and you're more focused. I guess that's why, you know, what trendy workplaces like Google always have these like hangout rooms where they've got these bean bags and stuff in them. And then there's some physical triggers. One of which is exercise itself is quite simple, and there's also some more psychological triggers, which is like being gratified in social situations and things like that, and people feeding your ego almost. So I just think it's kind of fascinating that you can literally train your brain to, it's almost depressing in a way, but yeah, you can train your brain to induce these states that make you ultimately focused. You're at your physical best, you're at your mental best, you're at your most creative. And if more people were able to do this, I think it'd be a bit of a better world. So it's definitely something that I try and look into, and something I'm looking into more, and something that I'd like to hack. I think that's the word they use. So look into it. Flow states. The chap's called Stephen Kotler. There's several lectures online about it. He talks with a chap called Jason Silver that I think I've mentioned before, who's like a futurist and philosopher, and they talk about these flow states, and it's really quite interesting. He has a cool story, so look it up. Love to see you.